And we're live.
We're live, we're live, yes. Good evening, everyone, and welcome. This is Twist Gaming, where you get to play board games with us.
See, even Aaron does it.
This is our weekly Twitch Loses at Descent stream, and we say Loses at Descent because we're main questing it tonight. Apparently, we can only win the side quests. So we'll give a quick recap of what happened last week, but first, who are we? I'm Matt.
I'm Josh.
I'm Aaron.
And I'm Twitch Proxy.
Didn't forget you were here for a second there, TP.
I did.
What's good?
I just almost knew. Twitch Proxy means you're playing, I'm helping you control the board.
And you're going to be rolling a lot of dice tonight. That's what happens with this game, a lot of dice rolling. So, Joshua.
Yes.
What happened last week on Twitch Plays Descent?
We went into the lair or castle of some elemental dragon.
Mm-hmm.
And got these cool elemental weapons. And we were like, oh, these are awesome. And they're like, there's these statues there. They're like, oh, can we have our weapons back, please? Or they're like, there were spirits. And we're like, no, we want these. Even though they were like hurting the hell out of us. And then we went and fought the dragon, and the spirits tried to help us, but they had no weapons to help us with, so they just kind of died.
Didn't do anything?
Yeah, no. And then we killed the dragon, and then we didn't get to keep the weapons.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, so it was kind of a...
It'll be fine.
Yeah.
But it does appear that I ended up with a new weapon anyway.
Yes, we did go to the shop, and we did have a bunch
of
XP.
We went shopping!
And we spent all our money.
I got a fancy new halberd.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I got nothing.
You're a pansy. We also leveled up our characters as well.
I see that. I have a new skill.
You do have a new skill. So
skills, what? Things?
Skills pay the bills. So is there anything else we need to mention before we hop into the fun?
I think that's it.
Yeah, it's a pretty simple setup. So as a reminder, we are playing using the app right now. So there is no overlord. It's the computer's the overlord. Skynet is the overlord right now. Which explains why we're losing so much.
Yes.
Right?
Is it Skynet, or is it like... I'm trying to think of the name of the bad guy in Reboot.
In what?
Reboot.
What's Reboot?
That
it's
old
cartoon.
90s
yeah.
Really bad CGI animation.
Oh,
show.
That one! It's like the first CGI show, right?
Yeah.
Hi, Voodoo Chow, and hi.
Was it a show?
Nothing?
From
yeah.
Ireland?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I have
yeah.
family there.
Your family in Ireland. We were just talking about that today.
At lunch.
I know.
Fabio lives in Ireland.
I know.
Hexadecimal. Yes.
Yes, thank you.
I never get invited to lunch.
You do.
Actually, you got invited like four times.
Yeah,
I know.
You don't love us enough to join us.
I have 30 minutes for lunch, and it's about a 45-minute drive from where I am.
Challenge accepted.
I am not a master of manipulating space-time.
You could Skype in with us or something.
True. That might be interesting. But so I digress. It is time for us to continue onwards. Actually, first, who are we playing as? So Twitch, you guys are playing as High Mage Quellen, and you are a necromancer, so you've got your skeleton reanimate, and I expect to see some funny skeleton theme names for whenever you summon one. So
like
TP
Skelly Osborne.
I was gonna say, give us an example, TP.
Skelly Osborne.
So I'm playing as Krutzbeck, which is this kind of grumpy dwarf that has a wolf companion and a halberd and Beastmaster.
I'm Avric Albright. I am a disciple.
The world's worst healer.
Yeah, I'm not the best healer. I'm a pretty decent tank.
Ooh, peanut butter and skelly.
Like skelly
that.
Donut?
Oh, skelly donut!
And Aaron, who are you playing as?
Oh, well, obviously, I'm Logan Lashley.
Logan Lashley.
That's your next D&D character.
If I have a, if I have a fat Skelly, would it have a beer Skelly? Look at Josh.
So stupid.
I hate you so much. And that's it. Good night, everyone. Thanks for joining us.
Before we get started, do you want to talk about the giveaways that we're doing this month first?
Absolutely. So we did our first two giveaways on our Twitch Plays Kingdom Death stream earlier this week.
Two and one.
But for our next $100 that we get donated to us, we're going to be doing another giveaway for you guys, and we'd like to theme it towards whatever stream we're doing. So, if it is this evening, I don't know what Descent theme stuff we have to give away.
We have random games.
We'll give
away
a board game.
Yeah, we have a lot of random board games.
We have, so that's exciting because usually our giveaways tend to happen on Kingdom Death Nights.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't really have a chance to give away actual physical games, but we have physical games.
We have a whole shelf of games.
We have five shelves of games.
No, give away specifically.
I know.
Oh.
We have a bunch of stuff.
I can't count.
That whole thing is all giveaway.
Yeah, that entire...
So
anyway,
we also are doing a subscriber giveaway. So for each 50 subs we get, we are going to do a subscriber giveaway. And how far are we from the next subscriber-only giveaway, TP?
We currently have 87 subs, as you guys know. Subs end and start different times. So a lot, like Kingdom Death, we had 91. Now it's down to 87. So if you aren't sure, double check that you resubscribed. If you're using Twitch Prime, make sure that you resubscribe, because it does not do it automatically.
Does not auto-resubscribe, sadly.
Does not auto-resubscribe. And I'd really like to hit 100, because we have something really cool and exclusive.
Really cool.
Really, really cool, you guys. What is it?
It is the Bears vs. Babies pre-release copy of the game that we got for hosting the playtest party. So we're going to be giving that away. It's unreleased as of yet. So guys, hurry up, get in on that bandwagon, and maybe you can get it too.
And we are discussing real life things to give away as part of our subscriber bonuses.
We are probably, what, a week away from having those finalized?
I think so. Sounds about right.
Josh is playing with tokens right now.
And Norfolk asked if we can win Matt. Matt is, if you take him out for a nice dinner, he's free. He's at the pay.
And, I mean, it can be in and out. He's not.
Yeah, he's not
picky.
That they mean the fast food burger restaurant.
I don't think that's what she meant.
See what you did there. You want to repeat your song, really?
No, I don't think that's within the terms of service.
Probably not.
I was singing Josh a lovely song earlier. Go into Discord and maybe he'll tell you. But other than that, I believe we are ready to start this evening.
You believe wrong.
So, TP, why don't you... Is there like a poll?
Do a contest.
A contest
if we're going to win or lose.
Is Twitch going to win or lose? And remember the name of the stream, folks.
Which is?
Twitch loses at the end.
That is a good name to remember.
A good name to remember.
You don't know.
I do know. That's why I said it.
Right, so do you want to start the quest now?
Okay, wait 1 second.
Let's start our quest in... Moth and Flame. Kildarth is dead, but signs of Merrick's rampage continue to spring up across the countryside. Fueled by his passion, perhaps it would not take much to craft a trap and find out what the mad mage is after.
So we're going to trap him.
Travel event. Spare a coin for my dying paw? A young boy asks, shaking an empty cup in your direction. Behind the boy, a wilted figure lays beneath a patchwork blanket. Only the man's face can be seen, and it is disfigured with bulbous, gray sores. So, do we want to donate a few coins, that's 3 gold, ask about the man's health, or just keep on walking? What do you think, TP? What would you do if you had the opportunity?
What's the question? Donate coins?
There is a young boy asking to spare some change for his dying paw.
Mm-hmm.
And you see that this man is underneath a patchwork blanket with bulbous gray sores on his face.
Bulbous.
So we can either donate 3 gold to them, ask about his health, or just keep on walking.
Tell him to get a job.
Get a job.
Damn
kid.
You, millennials. Just get a job.
Yes.
That's how it works.
Back in my day.
Aaron, I'm sorry.
Bulbasaur? Yeah,
I'm sorry. Bulbasaur. Logan Lashley. What would you?
Thank you for the
job.
What's up?
I think we should ask what's going on.
Josh, how about you?
I mean, we could at least ask.
I think asking doesn't hurt. So I'm gonna say we ask about his health.
I put up a poll.
Oh, did you really?
I did.
Oh, I didn't know that. Well, so everyone vote in the poll. Let us know what you want to do.
They want to tell him to go get a job.
Yeah, I heard that.
They took her jobs.
And they want to know that it's Bulbasaur.
I don't think that it's Bulbasaur.
You like Bulbasaur?
No.
What is he ranked in your top 3 starting Pokemon?
He's probably number 2. I prefer Squirtle.
Squirtle's the best.
Just because I really enjoy the Blastoise evolution the most of the 3. Charizard's kind of an a-hole, and Charmander's nearly unusable for, like, the first two gyms.
Ah, I remember.
Because it's rock Pokemon and then water Pokemon. So, yeah.
That's why
Bulbasaur's the best.
Bulbasaur's the best specifically for that, but I think he's the weakest final evolution, I want to say. In terms of actual attack powers.
I think he's the only dual one, though, because he's...
Plant Poison?
Plant Poison, where you just have water, and I don't even think Charizard gets Fly.
He does get Fly.
I think in the newer versions he gets Fly.
But he used to get Fly back.
In the original one?
Pretty sure he did.
I don't know.
He's a flying dragon.
But Squirtle, I mean, that was a...
Squirtle had really cool glasses in the cartoon.
Well, the Squirtle Squad Squirtle.
Squirtle Squad Squirtle.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, Squirtle Squad Squirtle.
You guys are being ridiculous. We're not still starting up. We're just debating Bulbasaurs. as we...
Isn't it a bit too early to begin the contest? Why was it? No, it's not early. It's 8:15.
8:15.
Squirtle Squad for life.
You're a Squirtle Squad.
All right, so what's the poll looking like?
I'll check that in a second. I'm just fixing up the salt meter over here, the placement of the salt meter. Anyone wants to see that salt meter rise? You know what to do.
No, why don't we? Why don't you tell everyone what they should do?
And let's
there
check
are bits in the cup.
This beautiful bowl.
Excuse me.
What?
What?
Poll results.
Squirtle Squad for Liff.
Donate.
Oh, we're giving them money. Okay.
Give
them
some money.
Only 3 gold.
The boy's face brightens as your coins rattle into his wooden cup. That's awfully generous of you. It won't go to waste. He scuttles over to the pile of rags and presses the coins into his father's hand, quietly encouraging the dying man.
I was expecting to eat the coins or something. I don't know why.
Because you're weird.
To eat the coins?
I don't know.
You started spreading the rumor a few days ago. Alric is being held in a cave in the wilderness. You do not put much effort into the lie. Merrick will come.
It's Alric.
Set aside tiles 2, 4, and 12. That's it?
That's it?
I'm confused.
2, 4, and 12.
We really appreciate it.
Oh,
thank you
for
the prescription.
Ooh, 3 months in a row.
Hashtag swag. Or would it be hash swag?
No.
Hash swag.
Hash swag. Come on, Josh.
Hedgehog?
Hedge
swag,
because
it's a hedgehog now.
Hash swag.
He's got a little hedgehog badge.
Hedge swag.
Did
you say badge swag?
I said he's got a little hedgehog badge.
Oh. You said badge swag.
Well, let's not repeat
where
that.
Where is this going?
James. Ooh, I like hash swag. Ah, see? I started a thing. I hope that becomes a thing.
Hash browns?
You sit quietly in this... Oh, did you need to... It's 2, 4, and 12. Right?
Yeah, I just can't find it.
You can't remember that. You've got some problems.
Swag hog. Hashtag bag swag. You sit quietly in the small cleft. The stone is cold and uncomfortable, but your discipline holds. You wait. You watch. Occasionally, one of you leaves to stoke the campfire you've just built down the hill. Your bait. High Mage Quellen just returned from tending the lure when you hear definite, unrestrained strides rustling through the leaves. You peer into the wood, preparing your weapons. Then Merrick is there, marching headlong into your trap.
Dun dun dun.
Place 2A, 4A, 1 transition, and 2 end caps. And then where's 12 go?
No,
I guess we can go into the transition.
No! Rule 3, everybody, rule 3.
No, you're all right.
No.
180. Transition.
180.
The transition's over here.
Turn at 180, Josh.
No, that's right.
Josh, turn at 180.
Oh, is that the black space that's just... Okay.
Thank you, Joshua! You should listen to me more often.
These are all ends.
We need
in the bit
one
cup.
Of these.
Oh, it looks like we got a response from our friend.
Our friend
Tony.
The tiger.
Why would you tell me this now?
I know, right?
And
you're not a human being.
And then I need a transition piece, which is going to be in the other bag.
Oh no!
I've got to add the pun counter.
The pun counter? We have a pun counter.
Nice try, Tony.
No, there should be one that's back. Transition. Hey.
No, nothing about how they're going to resolve the problem or anything. Okay, so continue. And TP, how does that look on the camera?
Let me see. It looks... pull it a little bit back for
actually,
you.
Actually, I just need an happy. It's not even
okay.
This. This is actually too big.
Okay, well, make it less crooked.
Place four red objective tokens as shown.
Red objective tokens?
These are pillars of fire. An adjacent hero can spend one movement point to attempt to banish the flames. The hero tests knowledge or the little star thingy.
Wisdom?
These ones?
Something.
These, they just have our... There's red ones in there.
Maybe that's like magical ability or something.
I disappeared.
Oh no!
There. There we go.
Okay. You breaking things?
In the back!
Place Lord Merrick Farrow as shown.
We need Lord Merrick Farrow.
Knock, 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 knock
him in.
Yeah, that's him. Where is he
going? Ah! That's trying to make me fall.
Because it would be funny.
I mean, I have enough padding. It's not going to hurt. All
right, next
Paddington
one.
Bear.
Continue.
Paddington Bear. Place three search tokens as shown.
A three.
Place the heroes in or adjacent to the indicated space.
Yeah, so many search
tokens. Really? No, yeah, don't answer it now, but...
Yep.
That's impressive. Set up complete objective defeat Lord Merrick Farrow.
Can you get the Lord Merrick Farrow card, please?
I can. Hero turn.
Sure. Go first if you're short, stumpy legs.
Yeah, I'm going to go first.
Lord
move me forward.
Merrick Farrow.
Why'd you put that in the chat?
What we're talking about.
Oh. Okay. So Josh, can you please move me forward three spaces towards...
No, to go into the water, you need to...
To go into the water.
To go into the water?
Yeah.
You need to use an extra point of movement.
Okay, so put me in the water here. And that is... That's one fatigue to get there, right?
Yes.
Okay, so give me a fatigue, and then I'm going to use my second action to summon my wolf.
Okay. That's another fatigue.
Yep. And then we
don't
say. And then
we're living there.
I'm gonna have the wolf move forward three spaces.
Three spaces?
Yeah. Like up, yeah, up in the corner there, so he's not in a line of sight or anything. No. I meant. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. And that is the end of my turn. Lord Merrick Farrow. After this activation, each hero adjacent to Lord Merrick Farrow must either move four spaces away from him or suffer three wounds. Lord Merrick Farrow engages as many heroes as possible within five spaces of this monster.
Technically?
Use Ignite on two or more heroes. Spot the closest hero, attack the closest hero, then retreat. So, he doesn't see me, though, because he doesn't spot me, no? I don't know.
Because there's nothing in line of sight? Is that what you're saying?
That's what I was assuming.
Okay, as many heroes as possible within five spaces. Technically within five spaces. Don't say anything about line of sight.
Okay. Okay, so he's going to attack Wolfie.
Wolfie.
He's got four movement. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, and he's going to roll...
A blue and a red.
Blue and a red.
And I need a great defense deck.
Gray die?
Yep.
You're a gray die.
Because I got Shadow Hunter.
3 damage.
I block 2. So you're going to take 1 damage. BFD. I hate you. Lord Merrick Stupid. That's his name, by the way.
Okay.
I made that up myself.
That seems appropriate.
So you either must move four spaces away or suffer 3 damage now?
After this activation, yes.
So you could die.
But I would still die.
Or move.
I already moved, though.
But it's forcing you to?
How does that work, Josh?
I think it's forcing you to move.
Okay, so move me back. Lord Merrick Farrow Fawcett. Okay, so who's next? Bueller? Bueller?
Which can summon Skelly and have him go attack him?
What's in the pillars again?
You can try to deactivate them by using your knowledge or your star thing.
Knowledge or my star thing. Oh,
yeah.
Damn, that's not going to work. That's not going to happen.
So I could work on the one pillar.
If.
But Twitch could run forward.
Yeah, Twitch can run forward and then summon Skelly, and Skelly could run up and possibly hit Pharaoh.
Yeah, they need to use 3 fatigue to do it.
TP, are you willing to spend 3 fatigue?
I suppose so.
Okay, so we're going to move you forward however many spaces, Josh, and then they are going to use their secondary action to summon the skeleton. So we need a name for your skelly, TP.
What kind of skeleton is it?
I don't know. Maybe it's a panda skeleton.
Then let's call it Skelly.
Skelly Griffith?
I like that. Put that in chat. That's
what?
Very good. I like that. Oh, I have a good name for the next one.
What?
Skelania Trump.
So you need Twitch to roll a blue and a red die.
So blue and a red die because Skelly is attacking Lord Merrick Farrow. Lord Merrick Farrow Fawcett.
TP, that was amazing. Keep it.
Yay! What is it? D blue?
D blue and D red. Which is dread.
Dread.
That's not right.
Because you all filled with it.
Is that working?
Should be.
Let me put your panda bot.
Josh broke panda bot!
Oh no.
No, Joshua. Joshua broke the panda bot. Whatever shall we do?
We shall not survive.
We will overcome. Okay, so this one is a little low. That's fine. I wish I had bits to put in the bit cup.
What did you do?
Throwing a table on you. You get it, because you're the piggy panda. I wonder if Josh is going to be able to fix PandaBot.
Hope so.
Since when does Josh ever fix it?
You don't know.
Wait. There we go.
I have a good one.
What?
I had a good name for the next one.
What? You have to say it.
It's the next Skelly, if
no,
I ruined...
No, the next one was Skelania Trump.
Try not.
Then I'll wait for 2 more.
Wait. Roll them dice. Roll them dice. Roll them dice. Yeah.
It works! But that one doesn't count, because I did it.
I did it.
I did it.
We did it.
We
did
it.
We also need a D-Red TP.
I do know that. I like how it's dread. You don't count. I didn't ask for it yet.
No.
Womp womp. So we need a D blue and a D red. I'm going to do the blue.
You're going to do the blue. Do the do.
A heart and surge.
That's 2 damage.
Do you have to do the red? 3 hearts and a surge.
5 damage.
Is that enough?
Rolls are gray and a block.
He blocks 5 damage.
He blocks 5 damage.
Well.
So you didn't do anything.
Wow, that's awful.
That's pretty terrible.
Yep.
So that is the end of High Mage Quellen, sir.
And it's still our turn. So who's going to go up next? Josh, you want to move up a little bit? Start beating on the poles.
Three movement to get to that. Sure.
How far away is he? He's really far away from there.
Yeah, he's 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, you ready for my next skeleton name?
Sure. How much movement do you have?
I have 4.
Skeleton B, because he's a scary sight.
4. So you go there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I mean, it's possible.
I'm preferential to skeleton C.
But it's scary spice. It's a double pun.
It's possible.
Yeah, but it's
but,
pretty athletic skeleton.
You can get plus
so
2 range for the surge, too.
Yeah. It wouldn't hurt to try.
So that means I have to roll a 3 or better if I rolled a surge?
Yeah.
That's most of them. That's not terrible.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do that. We'll move over there.
What you got there, TK?
Over there.
This is how I feel about you right now.
You can't
I'm
see
going
it.
To search. And use this to be able to attack also.
Okay.
So I'll take a fatigue for that.
Can you hit the search token?
We're going to search.
I mean, I can click on it. Who's going to search?
No, hit it. Logan Lashley.
Logan Lashley.
A dark object is hidden beneath a bush.
That's what she said?
You find 12 gold. Discard this token and draw a search card. Hey, TP. I did it. You didn't.
Uh-huh.
Alright, and then you're attacking.
Alright, options are health potion and power potion.
Potion central.
Flip this card over to reroll some or all of your dice after performing an attack. I'm gonna keep that one.
Alright.
Put this health potion back. Bottom. I need a blue and a yellow.
Wow.
And when do you get plus 1 damage for being away from everyone?
Yes.
Okay.
That's a good roll.
So that's 3 damage and 2 surges.
But
so
is that range? And that's only 4 range.
It's only
5.
4 and I needed 5?
Yeah. Yeah, 5.
Oh, poo. You missed.
Did you break it?
I could
broke
immediately
it.
Use this potion.
Good.
What does the potion do?
Lets me reroll one of the dice.
Or reroll the blue
one?
Because there's no range on the yellow?
Right.
And you already have the surge?
So I got the... I mean, other than the miss, I got the only side on here that doesn't let me hit.
Yeah.
So as long as I don't miss, then...
As long as you don't miss, or roll the same thing again.
So it's a 4 out of 6 chance of succeeding?
6.
There you go.
Oh, what? So you have enough range now, and now you have the double surge to do 3 extra damage.
Ooh.
So you do 5 damage.
Ooh, now he's going to block 5.
No, I do 6 damage.
6 damage. He only blocked 2, so you do 4 damage.
Nice.
4.
Bam.
That is the end of Logan Lashley's turn. Yeah.
I don't need to keep this potion, right? It doesn't do us any good now.
You just
Joshua!
It's just
Josh, it's your turn.
I'm going to go here, and I'm going to activate this thing.
Let's see what you have to do.
Okay, test it.
Adjacent heroes can spend 1 movement point to attempt to banish the flames. Test knowledge or stuffy.
I got 3. And I have 4.
Pass. You touch the blazing pillar and the fire shrinks away from you as if a living thing. Flip this objective token to its face down side.
Woohoo. Alright, Santa Marta.
Each face-up red objective token performs an attack as if it were Lord Merrick Farrow, and attacks the closest hero.
Oh, well.
Well, then.
Skelly's dead.
Yes,
are you sure?
Are you sure?
Blue and red. Do they move?
No.
Does he have range? He doesn't have range, right?
No, he's a ranged attack.
Yeah, he's a ranged attack.
Oh. Well, there you go.
Oh, yeah, Skelly's dead.
5 to Skelly.
Skelly's dead.
That one.
Technically,
the
they roll
two.
A brown die, but he's only got.
He's got
4
health.
So they technically could. TP, we need a
brown
die to be rolled. So can you please roll to brown? And let's see what brown can
I
do
have a really
for
good
you.
New name. A really good new name.
What?
I don't want to tell you.
Is it Skelly Bean?
Ooh. Skelly Bean Games.
Blank.
A blank.
Blank.
Unfortunately, that means that Skelly's dead. So Skelly's dead. And can the other ones actually attack anyone?
No.
Okay.
What about...
The guttering flame leaps into full blaze once more. Flip each face-down objective token face-up.
So they're just going to keep attacking every turn unless we flip them.
For real?
That's annoying.
Scalena Bonham Carter.
I hate you so much.
Alright, so what's the plan here?
Well, the plan would be I would like to attack him. However, Twitch is kind of in my way, so I think the best opportunity would be for High Mage Quellen to summon a Skelly and then attack with it, and then Skelly could play Sacrificial Lamb for the pillars again.
Can't you move through friendly, too?
Can you move through friendlies?
You could also move where your wolf is.
I just thought you couldn't end your turn on this other space. I thought you could freely move through them.
Oh.
I mean, it wouldn't have hurt for Twitch to go first. That's not a big...
I'm going to go first. So I'm going to move 1, 2, 3 and spend my last fatigue and go 4. And then I'm going to use...
Why don't you go first with your wolf?
What difference does it make?
Because your wolf... Oh, your wolf can stick up there.
Yeah. So I'm going to use my special ability, my heroic feat.
You do it after dice rolled.
Oh, that's right. So I'm going to roll a blue and a red. I'm going to do that, yeah.
Okay.
And I rolled... Oh, that's terrible. 3 hearts.
I'm using your ability.
Yes, I'm going to use my ability, so I'm going to turn this over. And then I'm going to roll another red die. I take 2 damage, and I do 2 additional damage.
So we're at 5 now.
Okay, and that's my attack. I can't do anything else with that.
He blocks 3.
So I do 2 damage.
That's not right.
He had 4, so 6 damage should be.
So now it's right.
Yeah. I was taken away from it before.
Oh.
So he was 13. He had 4 damage done to him, so he's at 9.
So now I'm going to run with my wolf up, and I'm going to use the Shadow Hunter attack.
So he has 6 health left.
Something else is going to go on right now.
He has 6 damage.
He has 6 damage, so he would be at...
7 health left.
7 health left, okay.
So I'm going to run up with the wolf and do the Shadow Hunter attack.
Okay.
So I'm going to roll 2 red and 2 green die.
What?
Yeah.
So many dice.
No blue die, so he can't miss.
And I can't miss. It's pretty awesome. Wow. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Pierce 1.
I don't know if you get the pierce.
Oh, I see what you're thinking, man.
It's got a surge.
Because it's not my normal attack.
It's not his normal attack, it's a special attack that doesn't have any surge bonuses. Box 4. So how much did you do?
7.
3.
So 3 damage.
And the wolf is dead.
Okay.
So that is the end of my turn. Lord Merrick Farrow. Each hero that suffers damage this turn, this activation is immobilized. Engage as many heroes as possible within 3 spaces of the monster.
Just you.
Attack me.
So blue-red. 3 damage.
Oh boy. Thanks, Merrick Farrow. You're so tough. I block 1. So 2 damage.
Alright. It's activated. You're also immobilized.
So immobilized card. I also need another fatigue. Yeah.
So Twitch, do you want to summon Skelly and then blow him up after he attacks?
Let's do it!
No, because then it'll hurt me. That's actually a good thing.
Kind of funny, though.
No, it actually is a good thing to hurt me right now.
Matt. Skellen Hunt.
Unless you want to go first and see if you can...
Skellen Skeller.
Snipe from where you are. Because
well,
you get the green die on top of it.
Yeah, I got that.
I got to move forward 1, so I'm not adjacent with you, but I'm thinking I'm going to spend a fatigue to do that.
Yeah, you can spend a fatigue to do that.
And then I can attack twice.
Okay.
Oh, Logan Lashley's attacking now. Logan Lashley.
I get the green. What do I get a green die from?
Logan.
If you have not moved,
I
if you have not moved
that
this turn. So that's up to you. Do you want the extra damage or a green die? It's typically one damage or a surge.
It has one range on it, though. That's why I wanted to get there.
It
because
has
the two wasn't enough.
50% chance of one.
That's fine. Because then I have. There's only the one spot that doesn't have enough range.
Yeah.
So it should balance out.
Three.
Four.
You need five. So you need to spend
a
surge.
One of the surges gives me plus two range and plus one damage.
So 1, 2, 3 damage.
Pierce any or no?
Yes.
Pierce two.
Oh.
I don't know if we played that before.
I don't think we did.
I think we missed that last time.
Yeah. So.
But he really blocks none.
He blocks none, so you do 3 damage.
Yes.
He has 1 health left. You get to do it again.
We're going
to
do it again.
I don't understand what's going on.
That's
enough
range.
That's 4 damage.
4 damage.
Pierce 2. Blocks 1. He dead. What did we do?
I'm confused.
You broke it.
Merrick lets out a snarl of pain. In an instant, he bursts into flames and streams towards one of the pillars. He stands in its center, pulling its essence into himself, drinking from the destruction it desires. As the flame disappears, you see his wounds knit themselves closed. Come on! He shouts, beckoning you forward. My fury is only beginning! Lord Merrick Farrow recovers all damage and discards all conditions. Place him shown and discard the objective token. Oh, so he basically has four additional lives.
He replaced that.
Place the lava beetle group on 2A.
What?
He's all up in your guys' grill right now.
Yeah.
He is
all
up in the grill.
All up in the grill?
Yeah.
All up in the grill.
So you have to do this, like, 4 more times?
Yeah.
So lava beetle.
That wasn't that hard, though.
Wasn't too bad.
Wasn't too hard.
That's what she said. We'll make a pill to help
that. Huh?
We'll make a pill to help that.
It's called Viagra.
Or Cialis.
Cialis. I need a lava beetle group going.
We just said on this tile, right?
Saw that.
All right, where do you want to put these guys?
Put them next to me. I could actually go and beat the crap out of them.
Okay.
Maybe. And that is the end of Logan Lashley's turn.
I'm going to do this.
He's gonna do something.
Lava beetles are going. Each hero adjacent to a lava beetle is immediately burning. Each hero who suffers wounds during an attack is burning. So I'm burning, apparently.
Well,
can you
spawn
the
hero within 6 spaces of this monster with the most heroes adjacent. Oh. So it's gonna be attacking Logan Lashley. This is the master lava beetle.
Okay, so he's gonna attack Logan?
Yes.
What are you doing?
I don't get it.
Burning.
Why?
You said you're burning.
Burns when it doesn't
matter.
Yes.
It
burns when you pee?
Yeah.
Get that looked at.
3 and a
surge. Is that an offer?
Surge. So that means it does blast. But they always have blast, so it's plus 1 damage. So it's 4 damage.
Ooh,
and it's also going to do 4 damage to me and to Merrick.
Okay. That actually works out.
So I block 1. So
Merrick blocks all of it.
3.
I block nothing. I'll block 1.
No, you got rid of our chat window.
Oopsies.
You butthole.
So 4, right?
That was like perfect clicking because that was nice.
Did you take damage?
Yes. So
I'm
going
to use this. Cure 1 damage. I cancel that as surge.
Cancel it.
So I take 2 damage.
I'd like chat window back.
I'm working on
it. Chat back. Why do you take chat away from us?
I'm working
Why
on
do you hate us?
God.
The minions are going to do the same thing. They might kill Lord Merrick Farrow here.
No, they did no damage to him last time.
Oh, why not?
because Josh rolled too good for him and too bad for himself.
Miss!
The other ones can't do anything?
Why not?
They can go somewhere else, can't they?
What's their speed? 3?
Thank you, Chappy!
You're not welcome.
Why are you so mean today?
Well, they do have range. So if they had range, they could have actually...
Yeah, Josh.
Yeah, Joshua.
You jerk. Josh is trying to figure it out. Like that show on Nickelodeon, where they had to figure things out.
You can't do that on television?
What?
that was Are You Afraid of the Dark, right?
Yes, that was it.
Salute Your Shorts.
Miss!
I never saw Salute
The last
Your
one
shorts.
Can't
like
do any... I'm going to have the last one attack you because it can't go after them. 3 damage to you, Matt.
I need a brown die for the brown eye.
Brown die for the brown eye.
Block 3.
All right, you're fine.
All lava beetles are activated.
So Twitch can actually have Skelly run in there, have Skelly attack the red one, and then make Kelly explode, and hit all the lava beetles.
It'll hit you too.
If he goes right here?
Yeah,
oh,
there.
I thought you went to the backside so it could blow up Lord Merrick too.
No, he can't get it.
No, that makes sense. So TP, we're going to have you summon Skelly.
I mean,
Skelania Trump.
Skelly Long.
Skelly Long. Mary Skelly.
So you're gonna cure one fatigue, but then you're gonna spend it.
Summon Skelly.
Summon Skelly.
And then Skelly's gonna run up into the fray and attack.
Do I have no fatigue right now?
You have one.
You have one fatigue left.
Oh, I do.
One fatigue.
And you're gonna
left,
spend
so you
it.
Have 3 tokens on.
Oh, I didn't realize I had tokens.
Yeah, you have 3
yes.
tokens on. So you're gonna have Skelly attack the red lava beetle. So when you get a chance, we're gonna need a D blue and a D red.
Red.
A D blue and a dread.
Okay. Dread's coming up and asking for the blue also.
De blue! My hooves!
5.5.
That's the blue. That's okay. So
three.
3 damage. He blocks
that's
1, so the master lava beetle is going to get 2 damage. And now, TP, we're going to have you blow up your skeleton.
So
we need you to roll a D blue and D red again. And we've determined that the lightning does work with that, too.
Yes.
The chaining, rather. So that could be really fun.
So they could do damage to Mara.
Oh, yes. So 2 reds, or 2 hearts from the D red, and 2 hearts and a surge
so
from
4 damage
the blue.
To all of them.
4 damage to all plus the chain.
This one's dead.
Dead.
This one's dead.
Ugh.
1 damage. And the red. 3 damage. That will kill the red one.
Cool. And then it's going to do 1 damage in addition to Lord Merrick Farrow.
Yep.
And Skelly's dead. But that was phenomenal. Skeleton just went in and killed 3 lava beetles. You got to kill Skelly.
No. Skelly's dead too.
And they're at
max fatigue now.
Why is that?
Because it spends the fatigue dude.
Oh, because it's
blown.
Excuse me?
Take it to the max.
Josh says it takes a fatigue to blow him.
Blow the bone.
Alright. My turn?
It is your turn.
I guess I'll smack Merrick. Though I probably won't do anything.
You can certainly try.
Do you have fatigue?
I do have fatigue.
Did you move the space away from me?
Yeah, it's moving the space away from me. That's not a problem.
So that way I don't have to move again so I can get the green die again next time?
Yep. Alright, so I'm going to attack a blue and a yellow.
You did.
2 damage with a stun.
And he blocks...
4 damage.
So he's fine.
But you had a thing so I can recover a heart, right? Or is it my surge?
It's on your surges.
Oh.
But I can recover a heart, my surge.
That's
1, 2, 3 damage. Blocks 1, so I do 2
damage. And a stun. On
and I stun
as well. A stun eliminates one of his actions, correct?
Yeah.
That's not terribly beneficial because he's ranged, but... That is the end of your turn. I forget what your name is. Avric Albright. Each face-up red objective token attacks as if it were Lord Merrick Farrow. So I'm going to get attacked twice right here.
Yep.
You miss.
Second one's going to go. 3.
Oof. That's good, though, because now my ability activates.
All right. Did you have 3 fatigue spent before?
I did.
TP, you should have 3 fatigue, not 2, because you should have recovered 2 at the beginning.
New round.
Wait, how many fatigue should I have?
3 used. Should have 3 tokens on you.
That's what I had.
Okay. All right, so how
I'm
going
to go first. Let me go first.
Can you get... Where are you trying to get to?
I'm going to go here.
I don't think you're ready for this, Skelly.
And then attack the beetle.
You do have reach.
Oh, I can attack Merrick,
yep.
Then. I'm going to attack Lord Merrick of Pharaoh. Lord Mia Pharaoh.
That's what Alan's like, right?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. I had to think about it for a second. I miss. That's sad.
Yep.
Says you fail.
That's the end of my turn. Lava beetles. If the target of an attack is an adjacent to the blah blah blah. Oh wait, I'm burning. You or figure. Oh, okay. So move me back. We're gonna have to redo that then.
Okay.
I'm gonna say that I rested.
Rested and.
That's it.
Nothing else you can do?
That's all I can do. Oh no, I can attack that thing and flip it
over. You can try to flip that over, yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna test my star.
Okay.
I passed.
Okay,
okay.
So this
flips over. So then I'm gonna rest. I heal all of my fatigue. Master lava beetles are going now. I'm sorry, yeah, there are
master.
Masters. Spot here within 6 spaces.
Most hazard spaces within 1 spot.
Technically that's me. It's still a hazard.
It's
space.
Not a hazard. I'm within 1 spot.
Right then. Or then or just go to
closest
spot
hero.
The closest hero. Is
yeah.
Yeah.
So it's going to attack Aaron. And it misses.
Okay, that's the end of that.
Flip over that token. If we flip them over...
You touch the blazing pillar and the fire shrinks away from you as if it were a living thing.
Doesn't attack.
Doesn't attack. Maybe he can't spawn.
Maybe he can't spawn it. So if we kill him now, maybe he won't be able to use this
one.
He'll have to use like that one. Maybe we'll flip over again. But if like we might
if
be able to do it for
one of them, like maybe we can get rid of a life.
Yeah. Maybe. All right. Who wants to go?
How about Logan Lashley?
Logan Lashley.
I don't have to move, so I can attack him twice.
And you have all the range in the world, so.
So I need the blue one and the green one. There you go. So I do 3-4 damage.
4 damage.
Josh, would you like a hot chocolate?
Yes, please.
5 damage.
5 damage. Yes. Use the powder stuff.
No.
No, it doesn't work.
I tried. It coagulates together.
What
so
you
get
try?
Like, last night, I had a little bit of almond milk with the peanut butter powder in it, and it was not good.
Do you want me to use the chocolate almond milk though?
Yeah, that's
sure,
a good
try.
Idea.
Or do you want me to use chocolate milk?
No, that's cheating. Don't do that, Josh.
Do the almond. I'll try that.
Aaron, would
so
you like a hot tea?
You pierced 2?
Tea? Yes, please.
You did 5 damage?
5
6
damage.
6 damage?
No, 5 damage.
5 damage.
With Pierce 2. Because I
Pierce 2. Alright, so he blocks one of those. So he's at 6 health left.
Kill him, Aaron.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So 5 damage again.
5. With the surge?
With a surge.
That
like gives
damage.
Me 6 damage, yeah. So
Pierce
2,
so 4 damage again. Yeah, 2 health left.
Okay, and that is the end of Logan Lashley's turn. Lord Merrick Pharaoh, after this activation, each other figure within 3 spaces tests the little star. Each figure that fails suffers 2 damage. Spot the hero with the lowest star within 6 spaces of this monster. I have 3.
I have 2.
That's you.
So it's going to attack that hero.
Blue and a red. 4 damage? And you rolled 1 defense.
Yeah.
So
take
3 damage.
Okay, and then each hero within three spaces, or everyone within three spaces, each figure.
Yes.
So it's actually going to hit the beetle, too.
The beetle cannot pass.
They're fatigue tokens, not bleed tokens.
We call this the star icon cat's buttholes.
We're fighting the butcher. All
right. That's awesome.
I
failed.
Passed. It's a four for me.
Okay.
They need to roll. Aaron, you need to roll.
Oh, I need to roll.
No, Twitch needs to roll.
TP, we need you to roll a D.
Oh my god!
And a D gray.
He passed. He rolled a one. One.
Thank you very much, TP. He
needed a two.
D black.
And a D gray.
D black and a D gray.
Well then, yes, it certainly does. When you know what's going on, it all makes more sense.
Will that make more sense?
Do you think Anne pays attention?
No.
No.
She doesn't pay attention when she's here.
I know. So she asks so many questions.
That is two shields.
And a blank.
They passed. Oh, everyone passed, except the beetle. So the beetle's going to take two damage.
Yeah,
and he's done.
Oh, he is going to
die. Let's just go with it. So I'm not here.
You asked for a D great.
I did. I wanted it to be great.
Like Frosted Flakes?
Frosted Flakes.
Frakes? Frosted Frakes. You sound like Tony.
The tiger.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah. Alright, so.
Oh.
What's happened?
So, do we want them to attack now?
Well, considering TP is quote tenning it right now,
I can't really.
You can
do
smack him.
Anything?
He only has two damage left, Josh.
I'll try.
Part of the cards.
Does anyone need heals?
No.
I have five damage?
Heal Logan.
I mean, it's... What is that? It's half?
Yeah, heal Logan.
Would you like me to heal you? My energy's better spent healing.
He rolls what?
I roll a red die.
No, he rolls a gray and a brown for defense.
Yeah.
So he rolls two dice for defense.
Yeah. And I roll a blue and a yellow. So, like, max...
Did you forget Josh's hot cocoa?
No, you said that you needed it back, so I'd get up in a second.
It's four damage.
Oh.
Yeah, that's fine.
Do you not need me?
I mean, we do, but like not this second. In like 5.5 seconds.
No.
We can have them, we can have Twitch attack.
They can go first, yeah, if she's here now.
TP,
do we
have
just
want to
attack them, just straight up attack?
Yeah,
straight
just
attack?
A straight up attack, because they might kill them, and if they do, then...
So you're going to heal fatigue.
Fatigue you.
Heal fatigue.
Lower your fatigue by one, and then we're going to need you to roll a D blue and a D red.
What if I want to roll black?
Oh, that's a defense die, so no.
D blue, D red. Let's see what happens.
And so you're attacking with your magic staff.
The right
dice. You know what they say.
That's a brown die.
Frosted.
It's a brown die?
Yeah, have you been rolling black
one? Yes, I have.
Oh,
oops.
Okay.
Oops, I buffed the bad guy by accident. Where's the brown die?
You been rolling two black?
No,
a gray and a black.
And it's supposed to be a gray and a
brown.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah, the difference between the black die and the brown die is like,
it's
like
a
lot.
Four. So four, they block four.
One more time, Toby.
Oopsie poopsie.
So it probably would have been dead after my attack.
Probably.
You had Pierce, so you...
No, one of the times
I
rolled four.
If we win this one,
yes.
We really deserve to win.
And the chances of it rolling four with the brown die, nowhere near as high as four
Maelstrom
with the black
die. Maelstrom rolled the blue and got a heart and a surge, and then Myantos rolled the red and got two hearts.
He blocks four.
Four.
So nothing else.
Apparently they're very good at
rolling. Really, Josh?
Yeah.
Really, Josh?
Yep.
And turn. So, Alvric Albright, it is your turn.
Well, now it's all up to you, Josh.
Do you want me to hit him? Or heal you?
Hit him. Kill him.
Two.
Hey guys, how goes the game?
I killed
Josh
him.
Wins.
Josh
I
wins.
Killed him.
Josh killed it. So, the lava beetles are dead too.
Yes.
I killed everything in my turn. Hey guys, how goes the game? Besides me accidentally doing things wrong.
Once more, the necromancer spirals into one of the burning pillars, absorbing its energy. Once more, his battered form recovers. We end this now, he screams, his eyes ablaze. Lord Merrick Farrow recovers all wounds and discards all conditions. Place him as shown and discard the objective token.
Fire.
Place the fire imp group on 4A. Is it the fire imp or the fire pimp?
So are we done with the lava beetles then?
Who knows? We'll just leave it
and
out.
And so it's the end of Alvric Albright's turn.
It's not the end of my turn.
It is now.
I'm going here, spending a fatigue to move there, and then I'm going to heal you one. I heal you for 3, Aaron.
Woohoo!
And I'll use that fatigue surge ahead of mine for that. And then I will... You need to move anyway, so I'm going to spend one more fatigue to move forward. And then... Cure my fatigue. I'm going to rest for the end of my turn.
Yeah.
Giveaway.
Okay. And these guys are gonna go on here. They ranged, yeah.
I think we should do a choice. What do you think? Next game, we should be a choice.
Sure.
Cause why not?
Sophie's choice. What?
More like Sophie's choice.
So for our next giveaway goal of 200. Which we used to go back into a stream and make awesome things.
Stuff and things.
We're going to do a choice between Codenames.
Woo!
Love Codenames. Codenames are my favorite games.
Remember to speak up because the microphone's all the way over there.
Codenames is one of my favorite games.
That rhymes.
And Ghosts and Candy.
Just like something.
Not Candy
and
Ghosts.
Like
this is Ghost Love Candy.
Ghost Love
Candy. Ghosts and Candy.
Casper.
Candy.
Casper likes candy.
I
Casper.
Like candy.
Casper likes to eat a lot.
I resonate with this game a lot.
That's Slimer.
Because I look like a ghost and I also love candy.
Is that you on the cover?
It is, actually.
With the mustache.
Yeah.
I will take that tea bag, sir.
You gotta put that in front of me.
Do you want
me.
A tea bag?
Here,
what?
I'll take the tea bag.
Oh.
Nice mustache.
Thank you.
I mustache you a question.
Final Fantasy Flight Games retweeted our tweet.
Wow.
Are you guys remembering to remove fatigue when you don't use surge and take damage when you have to take a fatigue but are maxed out?
Number one, I forgot about that one. Number two, we haven't had that happen.
Wait, you get to remove a fatigue if you have extra surge?
I did not know that.
I didn't either. That's nice.
Really?
Yeah.
Cool.
Apparently, so note for a future thing. We normally use all our surges typically, but... We'll make sure we do that. All right, so what's the Master Fire Imp's doing?
The Master Fire Imp is spotting the closest hero who is adjacent to another hero. That's no one near them. Attack a hero within 3 spaces of this monster who is adjacent to another hero, or attack a hero who is within 3 spaces of this monster.
So they're going to spot the closest and just move towards you?
Yep.
They can't go that way.
What?
Those are red box ones. So they have to go around those. They can't go through those.
Oh, thank you. So 1, 2, 3.
Oh, I didn't even notice that.
1, 2, 3, 4. They still can diagonal around it.
And they can't attack me? Or they gonna
attack? Just said spot the closest hero.
Attack hero within 3 spaces of this monster.
But they have
were over here when they started.
Oh, okay.
So they had to double move to get there?
Yeah.
They're not ranged?
They are ranged, but it doesn't... I'll make them attack you.
It makes sense for them to attack
so,
me.
Well, okay, so then you have to move them back some, then, right? Because you moved them 5 spaces. So how far did you move
they
them?
They have 5 moves.
5, so we're good now.
That's the best inside joke ever.
First ones are 2, 3 damage.
Okay, and I need the DeBrown. I block 2, so I'm going to take 1 damage. And next one.
2, 3 damage.
And I'm going to block 5.
All right.
That was the best possible roll I could have gotten there.
So it was. Masters are activated.
And the minions spot the closest hero who is not burning. Oh, I forgot to do that. You or a figure adjacent to you may perform an action to discard this... Okay, so I would have discarded that when I had that extra action on my turn. When I didn't
you didn't have an extra action. Because you flipped the token over instead, and you rested.
Did I flip it? No, the flipping the token is...
That was last time.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So, you suffer a...
I suffer a damage.
You suffer a damage.
I'm getting a lot of damage here. 9 damage out of a possible 15.
Okay.
So he's going to attack a hero within 3 spaces. I am.
There you are.
1, 2, 2 damage.
Everyone's attacking me.
Yeah.
So nice. I block it.
3 damage.
I block it.
The other one can't. Maybe.
Is there line of sight there?
4 damage.
Yeah, there's line of sight.
4 damage.
Oh. I have 13 out of a possible 15, Josh. Healer.
You can heal yourself too.
Use your magic crystal. It'll make you feel better.
Each face-up red objective token performs an attack as if it were Lord Merrick Farrow. Am I gonna die here?
You'll just get knocked down.
1.
Are you dead?
Yep, I am knocked down. Or incapacitated, knocked out. Thanks, healer. Best healer.
I asked if anyone needed healing last turn.
Well, I
the
didn't expect to get attacked
was
by 8 million people.
Well.
Well, next time you know.
Would you like to try an experiment on strands?
What the hell is that?
It's the cookie butter thing to get you.
I don't want the
cookie butter?
No, it's cookie. It's chocolate chip. It's not cookie butter. It's
chocolate.
Peanut butter chocolate chip. How was it?
He's eating the spoon, so it must be good. Yeah.
Is it good?
So that flips back over now.
Yeah.
It's very oily.
It's not very sweet.
Really?
New round.
Rule 3 means it's Josh's fault. Exactly what you just said.
Rule 3 is it's always Josh's fault.
Can you knock yourself out?
I can certainly try.
And you get rid of burning.
That's
the burning stops when you get unconscious.
That's fortunate.
So can someone, Josh, is there any way you could stand me back up? So that way I can do a whole bunch of attacks.
1, 2, 3, 4. I can. Definitely can.
1, 2, 3, 4.
And can.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. That's fine.
I'd really appreciate it. Just ask back for
you. You want me to heal you?
Yeah, stand me up and heal me.
Alright, so I'll stand you up. I roll.
You roll 2 red die, right?
Yeah,
that's what
right.
I get back. So I heal 5.
Heal
so
5.
I have 10 damage. Okay.
And then I'll spend a fatigue and heal you additional 3.
Nice.
That's
perfect, because now I have 7 damage and I need 6 damage to activate my special ability.
Okay.
That's
and
can you replace my mini?
You come back on the board. You're here. Hopefully they don't activate again.
I'm going to use one of my actions to summon my wolf, just because if the wolf is there,
well, make
KO
it so
myself.
You're okay, or yourself, and then end my turn.
Recover.
Avric
Fire Imps. Yay. I wanted to summon my wolf first, but whatever. Each attack gains +3 range. If the total range exceeds the distance to the target, it also gains Pierce 1.
Okay.
Okay, attack here within 6 spaces of the monster at the highest speed. That's not me.
That's me. So, blue and yellow. 1, 2, 3, pierce 1.
Block 1, so pierce 1 negates that.
So you get 3 damage.
And then?
The next one goes. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Pierce 1.
So block 2, so I take 2 damage. I need some more hearts.
I have a bunch over here.
Okay. Alright, that's the 2 monsters.
And now the minions are going, same exact thing.
1, 2, 3, pierce 1. 3 damage. to this one, 2 damage. And then the last one, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's still pierced one, so 3 damage. I am knocked out.
Oh no!
No, wait.
Don't forget your shield.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, if that helps me at all.
It does. Emotionally.
That would be block 3, pierce 1, so 2. I still take 2 damage and die. I can't.
What did the surge do?
The surge doesn't do anything. Not for the regular ones, and the master ones didn't surge against me. So I'm dead.
So you can't block, so it doesn't help anything.
I'm KO'd.
Last case of emotion.
Can you,
knock out Avric Albright?
Yep.
Oh, we only have one more KO.
Mm-hmm.
It is my turn. I'm going to summon my wolf with my first action. So, can you put Wolfie on the board, please? I'm going to have Wolfie attack the imp in front of it.
Okay.
And he missed. So then I'm going to attack the fire imp in front of the wolf.
Okay.
And I missed.
Well, that was unfortunate.
That was a great turn there. Lord Merrick Farrow. Lord Merrick Farrow may attack more than once. Each attack gains +2 damage. Spot the closest hero, attack the closest hero.
He's behind the wall, so he can't? So he has to move.
1, 2, 3. And a blue and a red at Matt.
1, 2, 3, 4. Range.
4 range. He got the range.
Got that.
6, 7.
7 damage?
Sorry, 3, 4 damage.
Oh, okay.
I was counting range.
Now I'm going to roll 2 brown die because I have the wolf adjacent to me now.
5.
6.
So he doesn't do anything.
Nope.
Okay.
That's why I wanted the wolf there. Merrick Farrow was a hit with all the ladies because of his pheromones. credit to Voodoo Child with coming up with the map pun there. And he can attack more than once. He can't reach anyone else. Okay. And so someone else go.
Let's see. I can move forward to 4 that I get, and then I can attack the imp in front of the wolf.
What you eating?
Line of sight's blocking you. Why don't you move your wolf here?
Turkey.
Matt. So.
Turkey.
Cold cut.
I like warm cut turkey.
2, 3, 4.
5 range from you, if you want to try to snipe it.
From where I am?
Yeah.
But then...
It's only too far from Oregon if you're walking.
But then I can't affect the other one, right? Or what's the range for this other one?
Polar opposites out of
same.
The
we're five.
Country.
5?
Yeah.
I need 1 surge to get a +2. All right, that's fine.
Staying alive.
Staying alive.
I have the range.
Here's the range by itself.
So which means that I've got 6 range. I've got 1, 2 damage, +2 surges, which means I have 5 damage.
5. And then you're also by yourself.
Two.
So it's a plus, that's 6 damage, pierce 2.
6 damage.
It did.
You shot the crap out of him.
That means I can attack the other one.
Range again. So
don't
3,
have enough surges for
4,
that.
5, pierce 2. You're dead.
Nice job, Aaron. I'm sorry.
Logan Lashley.
Yeah,
the time age Quellen's turn now. Twitch, that's you.
So what can TP do?
Well, they're going to cure 1 fatigue at the beginning of the turn.
So, TP, please reduce your fatigue by 1.
I suppose
or
I can
gain
do
a fatigue, too. Technically.
Shut up. Okay, so
wait,
then.
I'm getting 3.
You should have 1 on your card. 1 on the thing.
Okay, so I have 3, now I have 1.
Right.
Okay.
So, Where do they want to go? They have four movement. We could move them next to me and then have them summon the Skelly and have Skelly go and attack.
Kaboom.
Why is my wolf over there?
I moved him out of the way so Aaron
could
have
so I could kill the imps.
Okay.
Do we got this?
Well, what move Twitch into place, Josh.
I'm seeing what else they can do.
How's your disgusting almond milk hot chocolate?
It's good.
I didn't put peanut butter in it.
Peanut butt her.
Can we move onto these spaces?
I don't believe you can. It's a pillar of fire, Josh.
Skelly.
It's a pillar
of fire. I want Skelly to go there and blow up.
It's a pillar of fire, Josh.
Do you guys want to summon Skelly? Or do you guys just want to attack?
I don't know. Twitch, what do you guys think we should do? Should we summon Skelly? Should we just attack? Josh, what are the pros and cons of each?
Summon Skelly puts Skelly there, so he's probably going to die from something.
But it means somebody else won't die from something.
Yeah, it just means someone else won't die from something.
So why wouldn't we just do it?
It's good. It's better than with water.
So are you.
Thank you.
So do you want to move and then summon Skelly?
I think that would be a grand idea.
Sure.
Great. So move that. You're going to take one fatigue, or you're going to gain one fatigue.
Increase your fatigue by one.
I could do that.
And you're going to summon... What's your skeleton's name?
Let me pop another one.
Skelly LeBrock.
I don't get it.
Blue and a red die.
That's the chick from Saved by the Bell. Kelly LeBrock.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What's her name? You sure?
I think so.
I'm going to go with R. Skelly.
Ooh, R. Skelly.
Yeah. I like it.
I thought it was Skelly Kapowski.
No, the actress.
Oh.
Skelly Kapowski.
The blue was a heart and a surge. Heart and surge. Oh, that's right.
You actually
that's
got the
random
fact wrong?
I did. I never watched Saved by the Bell. I think that's why I thought that was her, because her name in the show was Kelly.
Yeah.
Oh, it's Tiffany Amber Thiessen.
Yeah, she was also married to Steven Seagal.
Oh.
And Elizabeth Berkley.
There we go, Elizabeth Berkley.
We need a red dice, though. Chat. Knock, knock.
Steven Seagal.
Oh, Kelly LeBrock. That's the British chick. The one that they make in the Weird Science.
Sure.
Three, four damage. It did.
Yay. Okay, so is that the end of High Mage Quellen's turn?
Mm-hmm. High Mage Quellen.
And turn. Each face-up red objective token performs an attack as if it were Lord Merrick Farrow and attacks the closest hero. So the one's going to go after Skelly. R. Skelly.
Four damage.
He has a brown die, so TP, can you please roll a D brown? And in the meantime, can you attack me, Josh?
You sure you want to be attacked or not? Twitch.
Have him attack Twitch. Ooh.
Five damage.
So
six damage.
After you get your D brown, I need you to roll a D gray TP.
Got a blank for the brown.
So Skelly dead.
Skelly Deddy.
D Gray. Coming at you with a D Gray.
Coming at you like a flu. I don't know.
Quick next.
Don't tell me what to
Continue.
Do. Don't tell me what to do.
You're not the boss, man.
New round.
You took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 damage, DB.
6 damage?
Yep.
Guys, we took 6 damage?
By the way, D. Brown played basketball for the Celtics. That's awesome. I don't want that.
I gave it to you anyway. Alright, so Who wants to go first?
I don't want to go first because if someone else takes out those lava beetles, then I can run up and smack Lord Merrick Farrow in his face hole.
Okay, question. How about Skellen Page?
Oh, there you go. That's
do you
want
to summon an elf skelly and attack it? Attack with him?
I want to summon Skellen Page.
So go ahead and summon Skellen Page. You're going to regain a fatigue,
how
but then spend it immediately.
Three movement.
So regain a fatigue, and then so I do nothing but my fatigue.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So put Skellen Page there.
Wait, one second.
Ooh.
Well, I would have them move
Skellen
forward
generous?
One with a fatigue. Then you could do one, two, or wait, hang on a second. One, two. No, that, never mind. You can get there with three.
Yeah. One,
Skellen
two,
generous?
Three.
Mm. Skellen Page now. So you guys are going to be
attack.
Well, wait. Oh, I wanted them to attack the.
But if they attack Lord America, then they make him explode.
They can blow up.
Oh, that's a good
and
idea.
And then clear up.
Didn't thing. Think of that. Okay, so yes, have the Skelly attack Lord America.
Skellen of
Troy.
Skellen
of Troy.
That's good. So we need Skelly to roll a D blue and a D red to attack Lord America Pharaoh.
Ooh, if it's in Wicked, would it be Skelfaba?
Can you have them roll a D blue and a D red? Skelfaba, I hate you. Skelfaba. What is wrong with you?
Three damage. Block two.
So he's going to take one damage.
One damage.
And TP, I need you to blow your skeleton up.
So you're going to suffer fatigue?
Not Skellen Page.
You're going to blow Skellen Page.
Why is the giveaway link not working?
Skellen trying.
So TP, you're going to be attacking through Skellen Page right now.
So
I need you to roll
I now have
a,
two fatigue.
Yes, and I need you to roll a D.
Three fatigue.
Three fatigue. I need you to roll a D blue and a D red.
You can do that.
You can certainly try at least. D red and a D blue.
D red and a D blue.
Dread.
Which fatigue do you have?
Two.
Two.
Okay, so we got three damage. Not much.
Damage.
Yeah, three damage.
Two damage, two. Lord Merrick. Two damage to this fire imp, which kills him.
Oh, they only have two health?
Yep. Two damage to this. Boom.
And Skelly's dead.
And Skelly's dead.
Okay. So, I'm going to spend two.
A second. Before you start doing stuff.
Well, they have to end their turn anyway.
So you do
get rid of the fire imps.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Aaron. Lord Merrick Farrow, after this activation, each hero adjacent to Lord Merrick Farrow must either move four spaces away from him or suffer three damage. Engage as many heroes as possible within five spaces of the monster.
So he's going to attack the two of you. So you first, Matt, for four damage.
Okay. Four damage, you said?
Yep.
Four damage.
I block it.
And then the Twitch. Five damage to Twitch.
TP, we need you to roll a D gray.
You might lose this there. Oh, they do have an extra health. That's not on the board.
Yes. How much damage was it?
Five.
So if you roll a blank, we lose.
Well, then don't roll blank.
A one. Literally, you have one health left.
Yeah, you guys have one health left. You guys have a leather armor. It's not up on the sheet. So you actually have a max of 11, but you have 10 damage to you right now.
I have 10 damage to us right now?
Yeah.
Ugh.
It's nasty. Master's activated. So I'm going to spend... What? What?
Can you possibly do 10 damage to him?
Yes.
Idea here... is... That's not going to work. No, that could work.
You're going to try to close those two gates?
If Aaron can come move next to me and stand me back up, I could possibly close both gates on my turn.
You think that'll solve the problem?
If he can't spawn on them?
If he can't spawn there, they're closed.
I can definitely do 10 damage to him.
Okay.
It's an action of mine to stand you up?
Yes, it's an action of yours. So it would just be a move and an action.
So, okay. So you're right. So, because I can't get there without
you can't get there with your fatigue. If you had, if you only had one fatigue, you could have. But
I So what's the plan, Stan?
No treasure over there yet. Yeah. I don't have anything to...
So the plan?
Go for it.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's do that.
Okay. We do that. You roll 2 red dice.
OMG, I leave you for 5 minutes and we're almost done. 3 health.
So I've 9.
9.
You want 9.
You act like 9.
Damn.
So I come back.
7.
6.
4, that's a pass, so the first one.
You touch the blazing pillar and the fire shrinks away from you as if it is a living thing. Flip this objective token to its face down side.
So you need to spend 2 fatigue.
Spend 2 fatigue to move here. Do it again. I don't
know.
It's
on the board, roll it again.
Suffer 2 damage. An instant of doubt crosses your mind as you push your will against the wild flames. As if sensing this, a cord of fire lashes out at you from the pillar. Suffer 2 damage.
Alright, I am gonna heal myself. 2 damage. And I'll spend, I lost fatigue there. I can't try to close it.
I might be able to, though.
But it's up to you what you want to do.
I'm going to do my suicide bomber wolf run right now.
Okay.
Doesn't matter where he goes. You're such a troll. I need the other red die, please, Aaron. Oh, that sucks.
1, 2, 3, 4.
4 damage. That's horrible.
With all those dice?
Block 2. So he does 2 damage.
2 damage.
And Wolfie's dead.
Now he's at 8.
I think that it still gets the Pierce 1. Because does each attack made by this familiar gains Pierce 1? It doesn't say this attack.
So I'm thinking of my damage from him. So he has 7 left.
Okay, so then I'm going to spend 2 fatigue to get into range.
Okay.
And then I'm going to attack with my halberd. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 damage. Oh, come on, Josh!
5? So 3 damage?
Yeah, how much does he have left?
4 health left.
Josh, come on!
Josh, you're so annoying!
Why did you roll a gray die with that?
Oh.
Did you roll the gray die with that?
I think I did. I think I rolled a gray and a blue.
Why would you do that?
So I re-roll this, right?
You re-roll because you didn't roll anything right.
Matt, re-roll your life.
Well, I could also spend a fatigue to
re-roll. Didn't you spend 2 fatigue to move forward?
Yes. Re-rolling it. Because you said I could.
Just because you didn't roll the right dice.
4. 6 damage.
Block 1.
5 damage.
He dead.
So what I was hoping was to kill him with that one attack, so that way I could use my other action to close that pillar.
How'd that work for you?
Josh broke it.
Rule 3?
Your cause is folly, Merrick screams. Again, he pulls the flaming power into himself, recovering. Lord Merrick Farrell recovers all damage and discards all conditions, placed him on their shelf.
He
came
the closed one.
He did?
Yeah.
Oh.
Just, so.
Place the Hellhound group on 2A.
I like all the fire things are going out. Is Reblo dead for anyone else? I think Reblo might be dead. Can you try to relaunch Reblo?
So the Hellhounds are attacking now.
Can certainly try.
I will. Oh, they should be in the other one. Yeah.
It's these ones?
No. These guys here. They look very familiar to those guys.
I really appreciate it.
I'm killing the bot.
Why'd you break it?
Hey, I'm sleeping.
All right.
So, each hero who suffers damage from an attack is burning. Engage a hero within 5 spaces who is not burning.
Stay for a moment. 1, 2, 3. All right, so blue and red.
all the damage.
Four damage, pierce, no, fire breath. Which is nothing. So, four damage to you, Aaron. Three damage. Four damage again. Two damage. The other one can't get in. So all the minions are activated.
Same thing for the masters.
One, two, three, four. Three damage.
One more.
Okay, that's the end of the Hellhounds. And it is Logan. Oh, you're recovered. I didn't unrecover you before.
And you didn't end our turns.
You guys won before?
Yeah, I tried to close. He recovered me, and then I tried to get the gates closed.
Each face up a red objective token performs an attack as if it were Lord Merrick Farrow and targets the closest hero.
I'm going to attack you. For four damage.
I block one, so I'm going to take three damage, so I'm at 10 out of 15. This is looking like a dire situation now, folks.
I'm going to heal us on my turn.
Okay.
That's it.
That is it.
All right, I'm going to go first and use my ability because...
Wait. You're going to go first, but Merrick Farrow is going to go second.
The Hellhound.
Oh, the Hellhound. Or Merrick Farrow, one of the two.
Yeah. But I'm going to heal everyone two red...
Power die.
Two red power die.
Okay, roll them.
So everyone is getting healed. Other red die?
In front of you.
Thank you. Four health is healed to everyone.
So TP, please reduce your health markers by four.
Health markers, about four.
So I flip that over. The rest of my turn, I am going to rest to get rid of all this fatigue.
And that is the end.
Actually,
six health.
Should I take out, or do you think we'll defeat him in this round?
I don't think we're going to defeat him this round.
So should I flip that over, restore my fatigue?
Flip it over.
Flip it over. Okay. I failed it. I'm going to take a damage.
You're going to take two damage. Yep, you take two damage.
So, seven.
So it's the end of Alfred Albright's turn. Hellhounds. Each hero who suffers a wound is burned. Oh, Aaron was supposed to be burning.
Huh. No. You were figuring...
So, engage a hero within five spaces who is not burning. Then engage the closest hero.
So it's going to attack Twitch.
So TP, you're taking 5 damage.
4 damage.
4 damage.
Pierce 2.
So
4
TP,
damage.
Well, first we need you to roll a gray die.
Roll a gray die.
What happens now? Is this the end of our adventure?
Yeah, I think it is.
Or do we get to respawn from the Flaming Pillars too?
I don't think it works.
They block three. Oh,
okay.
So then I take one. You take
so
one damage.
One damage.
So seven.
We still have three fatigue.
Yes.
And keep activating the rest of the minions. And they're burning now.
They're burning now?
Yeah.
So now they go after you?
They're going to go after Avric Albright.
They can't get to me.
Okay, so that is the end of that.
So.
The master's going to do the same thing. The
is he
going to
attack
you? It says the closest hero.
Who's not burning? Then engage the closest hero.
Yes.
So, you're going to attack 4-4.
4-4.
How much health do you have left, Aaron?
That's 3. Which means that...
And then the other one missed you. And then what's the master doing?
Same thing.
Closest hero is not burning. 2 damage to me. Block the other one.
Okay, it is our turn. So the problem is these hellhounds are in my way now. Technically, I don't need to move to attack them, though.
No, technically you attack the
master.
If you want.
Yeah, I'm gonna attack the master hellhound.
Or do you want me to kill the hellhound? How much do I have? 6? Do you want me to kill the hellhounds?
No, the hellhounds are done for this turn.
Do you want him to attack? Do you want Twitch to attack Alvaric? And then he could attack, and then he might.
No, you're Alvaric.
I mean,
Merrick.
Merrick. And then he might spawn in front of you and then you could.
I think we would be
him.
Best suited to get rid of as many of these hellhounds as possible.
Okay.
So let's all go for the hellhounds. The thing is, Merrick's probably going to attack Logan. Unless Logan moves.
How's your health?
I have 7 out of 10, so I have 3 health left.
3 health left? And you're burning?
Yes.
Can you heal him, Josh?
So I will take
one. I already went. That's the first one to go.
At the end of my turn, I will take 1 damage. To leave me with 2.
They could summon Skelly to blow him up here.
How much health does Merrick have?
He's got his full 13.
Is there any way that you could possibly kill him right now, Aaron? I mean, Logan.
If Twitch and
if
him
I
attack,
rolled, like,
he's gonna attack after whoever goes next.
I would have to roll like perfectly.
Wait, you know, Twitch could summon Skelly and move Skelly into a space that Merrick would attack and be the sacrificial lamb, right?
Yeah. So
I would have Twitch move, attack, and then summon Skelly as close to Merrick as possible.
Yeah, they could do that.
Okay, so we're gonna have Twitch attack Lord Merrick Farrow. So
let's do it.
Key, if you could please roll a D blue and a D red.
D blue's coming. And guys, if you could roll a D red for us too. Exclamation point D blue one word and exclamation point D red one word. We're gonna make this happen. Wonder if Rebel is working yet. Perhaps.
Perhaps. So there's 2 damage. One of brown. 1 damage. So they do 1 damage to him. They recover 2 fatigue, but they're going to spend 1.
So you should have 2 fatigue on your character sheet, TP.
Okay.
And then
instead
roll
one.
A blue. And actually, you're going to actually. It's going to stay at 3. Because you can use a fatigue to move back. Do summon Skelly in 2 range.
And Skelly, can you please attack Lord Merrick Farrow? And again,
what's Skelly's name?
We need a skeleton name. Skellen Hunt?
Skellen Hunt.
We need Skellen Hunt to attack Lord Merrick Farrow with a D blue and a D red.
Skellen Pompeo? Pompeo?
That could work.
Gonna go.
D blue's coming. D red's falling. Let's do this. D red is going to be 3 hearts.
That's a solid start.
And then blue is a heart and a third.
5 damage.
He blocks
one.
So he's going to take 4 damage. That's a nice hit by Skelly. All
right.
So that is the end of High Mage Quellen's turn.
Looks like Revlobot is working. That giveaway is up. You don't need to be present to win. When we hit our next tip goal, we'll be doing a giveaway. It'll be your choice of Ghosts Love Candy or code names.
So attack the Skelly, please.
See you should enter now.
I was hoarding them. I'm sorry.
I see that. 4 damage.
TP, can you please roll a D brown? What can D Brown do for you?
He's also going to attack. He attacks. Gets as many heroes with him as possible in 3 spaces. And he gets 2 actions, so he's going to attack also for 4 damage.
That might not be good.
Aaron's about to die. A blank. So
Skelly's
dead. Oh!
Yes.
That's actually.
So you take 1?
Yeah.
Take 1 damage.
Oh. Okay. That is the end of Lord Merrick Farrow's turn.
What do I want to kill?
Who knows?
Probably Lord Merrick Farrow.
Do it.
Okay.
They see me rolling.
Nobody's by me.
Because if you would actually, because if you could possibly kill him, then I could attack him twice, and we have an off chance of killing him.
Actually, of killing him, killing
yeah.
him. That's 4, 5, 6.
Pierce 2.
Pierce 2. 6 damage.
It's got 2 health left.
Two, three.
Yeah, he's dead. Dead. 5. Good job, Logan Lashley.
Logan Lashley.
Defeat unique. Thought I clicked it. With a howl of anger, Merrick streams through the last pillar. The flames follow, spiraling around him in a growing inferno. The blazes, bearing Merrick within, strikes the small cave in which you waited. Lord Merrick Farrell recovers all health, discards all conditions, remove him from the map, and discard the remaining objective token.
Okay.
Remove him from the map.
Remove him from the map?
That's what it says.
Okay. And discard
the and discard the remaining objective token. As the crimson fire of Merrick's form washes over and through the wall, the rough stone bursts outward into a shower of smoldering pieces. Remove the end cap and place 12B in one end cap. The board's growing, TP.
Of course it is.
Place elementals as shown. Meet a master elemental.
Master elemental.
We have them out, don't we?
No, he's the...
Oh, those are the big ones?
The big guys.
Place Lord Merrick Farrow as shown. Place 2 search tokens as shown.
Just a hair. Of course.
A freckle past the hair.
Where'd you hear that?
Okay.
Is that a saying?
Sure. Why?
Heather used to say that all the time.
Where do you think I got it from?
Stop. Freaking me out!
That's a scary elemental.
It's the end of
Logan Lashley's turn. Elementals. Water affects each hero on the map.
Nothing.
What does it say?
Each hero adjacent to this monster must test the star. Each hero that fails suffers 2 fatigue.
Master Elemental, attack a hero within 3 spaces. Spot the closest hero. Use water. Can't do any of that.
Nothing.
Is that the closest it's getting?
Yes.
Is it the biggest it's getting for right now?
Yeah. So I'm going to attack the Master Hellhound that's in front of me. Josh, can you move your hand? I need a blue die.
Can you push it just a little bit closer to the book? Yeah.
8 damage.
You dead.
And then with my second action, I'm going to rest.
Okay.
So that is the end of my turn. And if you leave me now, you take away the biggest part of me.
Leave me now.
Okay, that is the end of our turn. It is now our turn again. So, who's doing what? I feel like you really need to heal Logan Lashley.
I can run away.
You could run away.
Run away!
You could kill 2 of them.
1, 2, 3.
You only have 3 health.
4. I can use my thing. I can get back to where I can search.
Actually, I can't heal you right now. I need to recover my fatigue.
Fatigue.
I think the best thing for you would be to kill 2 of those hellhounds.
But how much health does he have left?
Okay, so that top one is closer to somebody that's not me, right? So if I use 1 fatigue to move over this way...
Well, if you kill this one and this one, then this one's also adjacent to Twitch.
So it could attack Twitch.
So it could attack Twitch.
Okay, that's fine.
Or...
Or
I could do something stupid.
Yes, do something.
And run my guy here and activate. Oh no, that costs 2. I can't do it.
Oh, I know what you're gonna do. Okay, so why don't you do that, Logan Lashley? Attack the 2 puppies.
So does it make sense for me to back up one? Or does it matter?
It doesn't,
I don't think
it doesn't matter.
Okay. Can I have the blue one though?
All the damage.
For
Pierce 2.
5.
He's dead.
What?
Dead.
He's dead.
Dead.
He dead again.
He dead.
And that is the end of Logan Lashley's turn. Logan. Elementals are going. After each elemental's activation, the elemental uses air.
Air is, until the start of the next turn, this monster cannot be affected by any attacks, and heroes may move through it.
Spot the closest hero, attack the closest hero in line of sight.
If it can't be affected by attacks, how can it attack?
So he will go 1, 2, 3, 4, and try to attack Logan.
Logan.
He's ranged. He misses.
Thank goodness. And it is our turn again.
Twitch, you want to kill the Hellhound?
That sounds like fun. Can we punch it in the butt?
You can poke it with your staff.
Two okay. Fatigue.
You're going to recover two fatigue, TP.
So you only have one.
I only have one?
Yep. And then we need to roll a D blue and a D red.
But I still have 7 health?
Yeah, 7 health and 1 fatigue token.
Blue and red?
Yep.
7 blue and 7 red?
No.
It's more fun that way, though.
Same result, either way. So we need a deep blue, 2 hearts. So four damage.
You're dead.
Nice. So, TP, what I would recommend doing here is spending a fatigue to move one space forward and then summoning your next skeleton with a silly skeleton egg.
We could do that, so spend a fatigue.
Why move
a
space forward?
Because then it summons them in the water and then the skeleton doesn't have to spend 2 movement points to go into the water.
Huh.
See, I thought of that, Josh. So, TP, you're going to increase your fatigue by 2. He's not affected by attacks this turn.
Ah.
That's fine, but the skeleton is now the nearest threat.
Exactly.
The skeleton
so
is
did
the
you increase tank. Your fatigue by 2?
I increased it by 1. We're increasing it by 2 now?
Yes, ma'am.
Alrighty.
And that is the end of High Mage Quellen's turn. Lord Merrick Farrow. Lord Merrick Farrow may attack more than once. Each attack gains plus 2 damage. Spot the closest hero, attack the closest hero. He's air right now, so the attack would go through him.
Yeah, it would still go through him. Yeah, true.
He missed.
He missed.
And it is our turn.
Who's turn? Krutzbeck and Avric.
Yeah.
I really can't do much right now.
Just rest.
Yeah, I'll
move and rest.
Move and rest.
You want to move
Hellhounds are going
to the
now.
Water.
Oh, I didn't kill the Hellhound group before.
Right, because you have enough to do that now, so it'd be better than having to do it later.
And it's my turn. Move me 3 spaces forward. And I wanted to summon the wolf.
Okay.
Okay. And that is the end of Krutzbeck's turn. New round.
You take a fatigue, by the way.
Yes, I do. And it is our turn again. So who wants to go first?
So is it elemental, or not until its turn?
Not until its turn.
How far away is Mr. Pharaoh?
From you?
Walk like an Egyptian, Mr. Pharaoh.
6 spaces.
Great googly moogly.
Great googly moogly.
I am next to somebody, so I will not get my extra die.
Unless
no, you get your extra die if you don't get your extra damage if you're next to someone.
Oh.
So if you don't move, you get your extra die.
So 6 is not out of the realm of possibility?
Most correct.
There's nothing to be gained from not attacking him unless we want to go find the treasure.
There's nothing really too useful.
4, 5, 6
with the surge.
So 7 with the surge.
7 with the surge, okay.
So then I have 4, 5 damage.
5 damage?
Here's 2.
Here's 2.
Do you have your phone on a table stand? The
so
table
he
that I'm supposed
blocks
to use
1.
To flip
so
the table
4 damage?
I need to flip the table?
5 damage.
5 damage?
So he takes 4 damage.
Four damage.
I'm judging you.
Should.
You also heal one, because you use that extra surge to heal. Or you could use it to recover fatigue, but I figured you want to heal one.
Yeah, getting one more hit point probably is good.
Okay. And you can do it again. Thank you for the follow.
Thank you.
Grazie.
I have 4, but I need 5.
6.
Okay, so I have to spend it on the range then.
Yeah.
So then I have 2, 4 damage.
Please make sure to follow
damage.
Us if you're not already. And
okay,
if
and you heal
really
one again.
Like
because you have that extra charge.
Because
you get extra benefits.
Because we're awesome too.
Yes.
Alright.
And at the end, that's the end of whose turn? Logan Lashley.
Logan Lashley.
Lord Merrick has 5 health left.
Lord Merrick Farrow's going.
I thought he died.
After this activation, each other figure within 3 spaces of Lord Merrick Farrow suffers or tests their cat's butthole, and if they fail, they suffer 2 damage.
What?
He
missed.
He attacks.
Skellion,
he
missed.
He missed, but all creatures within 3 spaces,
so
Elemental's going to hit it, too.
Okay, so the Elemental takes 2 damage, and Skelly takes 2 damage.
Right.
But Skelly's still alive.
Yep.
Alright, so I'm going to say... Activate.
Cat's buttholes.
So Twitch can actually have Skelly move here, because he's air now.
Oh, he's still air.
He can
yeah.
attack them and then they can blow him up.
That's a solid choice.
So,
TP, please roll a D blue and a D red. You're attacking Skelly onto the air elemental.
You're gonna recover 1 fatigue.
D red.
And also reduce your fatigue by 1.
Attacking the air elemental.
No,
he's attacking
Lord Merrick Farrow.
And then
okay.
I'm gonna go.
He's moving through the.
Yeah.
I heard air elemental.
Yeah, I said that.
He said.
Just ignore me. 5 damage.
5 damage. Ooh.
Woohoo!
Block 1.
He has 1 health left.
So TP.
Yeah.
What's the name of your skeleton? Helter Skelter.
You're gonna spend a fatigue and blow him up. So throw blue and red.
So
you
I am max out on fatigue right now?
Yes, you are.
You got 3.
3?
Yeah.
Max, rather. So we need a D blue and a D red. You're going to be blowing up your skelly.
I'm going to call him Water Skellen.
It's 1.
That's 1. And that's 3.
3. He did!
So we, you, okay. Defeat unique. Is that the right one?
Yeah.
Scum, Merrick hisses. You're all scum. Anger yet burns in those eyes, but the mage tosses his weapons to the floor. I'll come willing, answer for my transgressions. But listen to me now. Alric has been captured, and a great evil is rising. I don't know why, but they wanted him. Needed him. You move to bind his arms, but he steps away. I said I'd go, but listen to me. There is one named Hestian. I believe he is to blame. If you doubt me, detour to Castle Thelis. His eyes meet each of your gazes. Then he holds out his hands for you to bind. Castle Thelis. There you will see Hestian's power.
I have the skeleton's name.
We won!
We won?
We won!
We won!
We won!
I didn't even get a name by skeleton.
Quest rewards. We gain 7 fame, 140 gold, and 2 experience.
Huzzah.
Can I name my skeleton?
He just
no.
died.
He's dead. You march Merrick back to the nearest town. After committing him to the local marshal and giving all manner of warning, you leave him there. Castle Thelis, a well-fortified and properly garrisoned fortress to the west. You desire to cast off the mage's instructions. Merrick is a cruel lord, and you have no desire to be taken up on his schemes. All the same, you are uncertain why he would send you there if not for the reason he gave. Perhaps in time, you will heed that direction and investigate his claims.
So, for those of you who bet on his winning, you win!
Yay! You won the points. But anyways, this has been our presentation of Twitch Doesn't Lose at Descent.
We won!
We won!
And I want to name my skeleton.
What?
Alexander Graham Scowl.
I hate you. All right, so thank you everyone for joining us this evening. It's time for the sign-off phase of things here. So first off, we'd like to say we hope to see you again for all of our future broadcasts. Coming up next tomorrow, we have a special presentation of The Panda Show. Hopefully they'll start on time, which is supposed to be 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
We have a special guest. I hope we serve on time.
We have a special guest. And who are the special guests, TP?
We've got Jen. I'm sorry, I'm blanking on her last name.
From Gaming Mommies, right?
On Facebook, yeah. And we've...
Two other special guests. She hasn't named them, no.
Oh,
special
guest.
Yeah.
Special
guest. You guys don't
want
to miss that. This is going to be fun.
It's going to be super fun. We're going to be talking about being a gaming parent. Gaming mommy, gaming parent.
I think I'm just going to sit back and watch and cry my eyes out for
and hold your ovaries because they're going to hurt. There you go. Other than that, then join us on Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time for our next spotlight session. And TP, we have that ironed out now, don't we?
No, it is not confirmed.
Oh, we have not. Okay, we have not confirmed. So the best way to find out what we're going to be streaming on our spotlight streams and all of our future streams is to follow us on Facebook, Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, and come chat with us in our Discord channel where the party never stops. On Tuesday, 8 p.m. Eastern Time, is our continuation of Twitch Plays Kingdom Death, where we're going into Lantern Year 5. That's super exciting. So, guys, check out the action there.
Pretty rough Year 4.
We had a pretty rough Year 4, but we still won. And then, worst case scenario, join us next week, Thursday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, for a continuation of Twitch Plays Descent. It's side quest time, it looks like, so we might win again.
Yeah.
Other than that, please follow us if you haven't done so already. Click that little heart at the top. We'd really appreciate it. Other than that, if you really do like what you saw, hit the subscribe button. All of the funds we get from that go directly into improving the stream, getting better equipment, making the broadcast better for you guys. And remember, if you have Amazon Prime, you get one free subscription every month, and we'd be honored if you use that on us. We do have some great IRL benefits for our subscribers. We're ironing out the final details, and those should be ready to start going out in the next week or two, so we're super excited for that. Also, guys, check out our group that we're a part of here. It's the Tabletop Gaming Network, where it's a bunch of like-minded tabletop gaming streamers that have all banded together to cross-promote each other and try and build up this community because we have such a great time doing it, and we believe that this community is an awesome one, so we want to grow it and make it better. On top of that, too, we would like to point out Tabletop Day is coming at the end of this month, and we've got a super special stream planned, a collaborative stream, cross-promotional stream. So that's going to be super cool. Am I missing anything else, though?
Make sure you follow us.
I said
subscribe
that.
If you want.
I said that.
You said the Prime thing?
I did.
Okay.
You zoned out?
I did. I'm surprised we won. I'm still in.
Yeah.
We won quicker than I expected.
Also,
it's
a
really
reminder.
Tiny map.
Yeah, also a reminder, guys, for each $100 in stream donations that we get, we do a giveaway. We like to theme it towards whatever stream we're doing. We've got a bunch of board games in our reserves that we can do as giveaways. We've got some custom made Kingdom Death esque. Promo posters.
What would that be?
Yeah, who knows about that? You know,
huh?
We've got the Dragon King Anne, we've got the Nightmare Panda, and the Hung Beetle Knight. Those are exciting. Everyone loves
those.
Do
you like me a good Hung Beetle Knight?
And then we've got our subscriber only giveaways that happens whenever we cross the 50 subscriber threshold. So the next one's coming out, and I believe 11 more subscribers. And it looks like right now you guys are going to have the ability to get the Bears versus Babies game that's not released yet. We got it from when we hosted the playtest party, and it is ours to give away to our fantastic subscribers. So that's one of the subscriber-only giveaways that we have planned for the not-so-distant future. Am I missing anything else, folks?
Don't forget to spray and neuter your pets.
Spray neuter your pets.
Spray your pets.
Thanks a lot, Parker.
Yeah.
You want to go raid someone?
Well, who's on right now?
Let's see. We've got Playing Board Games doing an early Kickstarter preview of Thieving Jerks.
Thieving Jerks. Let's
Thieving
do it.
Thieving Jerks.
So, guys, we're going to go say hi to Playing Board Games. Let's send them all some mad up, some pandas, some piggle snorts. Whatever you guys want to put up there, but just show some support to our fellow awesome streamers. With that, though, this is Twist Gaming signing off for this evening. We hope to see you all again soon. I'm Matt.
Josh.
I'm Aaron.
I'm TP, and why can't I use my own subscriber buttons?
Ba-dum-ba-dum-ba. So are we raiding someone?
Yeah,
that
we
must
are.
Be a happy little accident.
Piggle snorts.
All right, guys, accident. We're gonna go raid playing board games. Let's go over there. Link them over here. Hi, I'm Daftaru.
Bye, Peter Chayward.
Bye, Peter Chayward.